I'm Harshpal Singh and I'm a part of FITTER since 2016. Today, I will not talk a heart-to-heart with you. मन की बात नहीं करूंगा मैं आपके साथ, आज मैं दिमाग की बात करूंगा. I will talk about a part of my life which is a hidden secret, a dark portion which I do not want to access. But today I will speak about it to you. एक टाइम ऐसा था दोस्तों जब मैं when I was going through really rough patch, I don't know what exactly was happening with me, but something was not right. Though I could not pinpoint exactly what. One day, 2012, 22nd May, evening I came down and flopped on the bed. बेड पर औंधे मुंह जब मैं गिर गया एंड आई डिडंट नो व्हाट वाज हैपनिंग, आई वाज टोटली आउट. फैमिली मेंबर्स केम, दे सॉ मी लाइंग इन दैट स्टेट लेट इन द इवनिंग एंड दे थॉट दैट आई वाज वेरी टायर्ड, सो मे बी आई जस्ट हैड गॉन टू स्लीप. बट दैट वाज नॉट मी. आई नेवर वेंट टू स्लीप इन माय वर्क क्लोथ्स, दैट टू विद माय शूज ऑन. बट नॉट टू डिस्टर्ब मी, दे सिंपली रिमूव माय शूज एंड let me lie there. Only that I woke up 3 days later. 3 din baad jab utha, so I had no energy. I didn't know what had happened during those 3 years. I had no idea. They took me to the hospital. There was a lot of testing going on, everything was happening around, injections and whatnot, MRI, everything was going on, neurological evaluation and also psychiatric evaluation. Things were happening, I was bewildered, I didn't even know who I was, I couldn't move, I had no energy left in me, it has totally drained me. I had no idea what it was. So it was like a new birth to me. I knew later on, I was told that it is known as a TIA or a transient ischemic attack. They also call it a mini brain stroke. But that was just the episode that had happened. What had led to that episode? Why did it happen? Was it hypertension? Was it obesity? What was the reason behind it? Exactly, they could not pinpoint. They could just say that something like this had happened. So I was reborn. I had to learn how to move. I had to move my limbs. There was total motor loss. And everything was started just like a rebirth, like a small baby is born again. I started walking, and later on when I started probing into it, I joined FITTER. I shed a lot of weight, a whooping 53 kilograms. Then again, there were episodes. Intermittently, one after the other, there were episodes. And I was getting back from a very fit level to the unfit level. I was falling apart. Something was happening. And you know, there was a stigma attached. I had stopped going to the psychiatrist. I had simply refused कि मैं पागलों के डॉक्टर के पास नहीं जाऊंगा. And maybe that was a very big mistake I had taken. I cannot tell you each and every issue that I faced, each and every medical condition that I faced. Maybe if I speak later on this topic, if you all want to, but maybe you can relate to when I finally decided that I should get myself checked and started probing more about mental health. And I started questioning my doctor, a psychiatrist, that what was exactly wrong with me. He told me that I was at that time having a condition called post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. So that was the first diagnosis, that I had a PTSD, and which is pretty common in people who go through strokes or a TIA, they get this particular condition. But it had started long before, when there was a family partition on the way. And those who tell you that there are amicable separations when a joint family is broken, well, it's just a myth, guys. There is nothing amicable about it. All sorts of allegations, all sorts of abuse, whether it is emotional, whether it is physical, whether it is verbal, it happens during a separation. And it happened in my case also. I had to go through all of it, the lowest of the lows. And somewhere, it created issues in the mental health. तो PTSD के साथ जो मुझे आया, the next thing that came along with PTSD was amnesia. I was having enterograde amnesia. I still don't remember what exactly happened during those three days. And thereafter, you know, there were episodes. For example, one day I joined theater later on, something I used to love in my college, on advice of my psychological counselor. And I was very relieved with that. But one day I was just, taking leave from the green room with my director, and I was finding my specs. All the while, I was wearing it. I didn't remember wearing it. I didn't know I was wearing it. I was helter-skelter finding it. On another occasion, I got down from the metro and simply forgot who I was, where I was going, and kept roaming about for 15 to 20 minutes. Total amnesia. But then, a mobile phone vibration brought me back, and suddenly I realized that I was on my way back to the metro. So during the period when I got down from the metro at that station, around 20 minutes when I roamed about on the streets, I had no idea. Almost 20-25 minutes later, when the phone vibrated, I suddenly took it out to check, and then I realized that I was on my way back, which was totally unintended. I had not planned to go back from there. I had to report to a particular place over there, which I had to totally cancel on that day. So these sorts of amnesia episodes have happened to me. Maybe some of you can relate to it. So once I started studying more about it, I got certified from the, I joined a Coursera course in from the University of Toronto at Scarborough, and got a certification in introduction to psychology, and I started helping other people at advice of Professor Judens, the course coordinator over there. So I started talking to people who were looking for counselors, and counselors, they do charge a hell lot of money. It's not exactly economical, it's pretty expensive. So when I started speaking to people who were needing some sort of help as a coach, as a life coach, I started helping them. I heard out to their queries. My motto was not to make money. Till date, I have not taken a single penny from anybody. But the blessings I receive in forms of messages, in forms of gift that they give me, these are very precious. I have helped people who were suicidal. I have helped people who were going through, verbal abuse, physical abuse, who were in relationships where they were caught up, where they were very unsure of themselves, and where they were going through a really tough mental health issues. And that is where I find a lot of solace, a lot of calm, a lot of peace when I'm helping these people. Because I don't want anyone to go through the same travails that I had to go to, and I couldn't find no one who was there to help. I don't want others to suffer this. That's why I joined it. So PTSD and amnesia are two of the things that I faced. There are more issues that I faced later on. If you guys like, I can relate that also on a later period. If you want me to speak about them, I can tell you more episodes about what happened, what was diagnosed later on. A lot of things came up in later on evaluations at the psychiatrist.